Alright, this is John Cole with growingyourgreens.com here with the garden update. I was gone for about a week now, just got back, and it's always wonderful to come back to my garden and eat some fresh greens. I miss them so much when I'm traveling. I just can't even approach the quality of this kind of stuff when I'm traveling, even if I hit farmers markets. So a lot of things have grown. Here's the bok choys. They're getting actually nice and big. Need to be harvesting some of these and eating them. Nice and big bok choys. Now the green bok choy has done really well and growing really well and still growing, but the red haven't been doing so well. They've already bolted. Let's see what else. Here's broccoli. We have broccoli growing in the back. They're growing and they're flowering, so you cut off the main stem and they throw up side shoots. We have all this nice baby broccoli growing. Over in this bed here, we have a newly planted kale. So we have dino kale and red Russian kale planting for the summer. Let's see, the dino kale will probably last through the summer. The red Russian probably won't. We have a big pile of sand and rocks, and that's because we've been Sage has been finishing all the pavers in between the beds, so now we're not gonna have to step in mud, although here it is just about springtime, and we're not gonna have any mud anymore anyways. Fig tree, let's see, brown turkey fig tree. Let's see, the figs are growing. You can see the little baby figs growing, and it's leafing out finally, so it's always a good sign. So now we're starting to plant things underneath the fig tree, like lettuces, that don't mind a little bit of shade, and it's gonna be a little bit of time before the fig tree fills in there. So let's see, the fava bean beds doing really well over here. It's got a lot of flowers, got some fava beans. We're gonna probably start selectively chopping them out before the beans form so that the nitrogen will be released back into the soil, because they are nitrogen fixing plants. Lettuce bed's been doing good. I've been selectively harvesting some lettuce here occasionally, so we're filling it with new lettuce, but you know, pretty much after this lettuce is goes through one more cycle, we're gonna pull this out, grow something else over here. The kale and brassica bed's doing really well. Some of the things are flowering. Here's actually a cauliflower that we just let go. And let's see, you have things like curly kales and red boar kales are all flowering too. Dino kale still doing really well. Next bed over, we got a whole bunch of greens. Did a lot of Chinese greens this year. And you know, they're pretty much short-lived plants. They're you know, they're kind of good while they last, but then what happens is they all go to flower. So I have all these yellow flowers, and pretty much we're just gonna pick the yellow flowers and the greens off that and eat them, and then we're gonna have some space to replant here. Next bed's pretty much the same thing. Have different cabbages and things growing. A lot of it's gone to flower also. But once again, we're preparing for the summertime growing. So here's an example of actually this bok choy we planted afterwards, and we intermixed the green with the red. And as you can see, the green here is growing really well, but now the red is basically now bolting, going to flower. And what happens is when they bolt, they get tall and straggly. And as you can see, you know, there's not any leaves or leaf to eat anymore. There's these small leaves, whereas the ones that haven't gone to flower still have these nice large leaves. So when things go to flower, it's kind of useless. Here's our new lettuce bed. Just planted those out. They're coming in pretty good. This is a nice shady spot. This is the herb bed over here. So we got parsley plant along the edge. We have cilantro planted in between the stevia. So the stevia was in the bed here before. We dug them up and they survived the dig up and replanting. So we have one, two, three, four patches of stevia here, and this is gonna come up and grow into nice big bushes. The cilantro in between will probably end up bolting. We'll pull out and put something else in, but we also have a collection. I'm starting to stockpile different herbs for this herb bed, from sage, thyme, lemon thyme, winter savory, more cilantro, and some oregano. So we're gonna get this all with different herbs so I could have fresh herbs whenever I'd like to harvest them. Let's see, oh, this bed over here has been doing really well. I've been eating some snow peas. So here's a snow peas here we could pick. It's definitely gone to flower and now it's been generating peas. There's a whole bunch if you look really hard. And below them, the carrots have been doing quite well here. As you can see, we tried to fill all our space up. That's all the carrots. Let's go to the next bed. Of course, the tree killer, tree collards, always doing really well. And the goal for this bed this year is to basically plant more of these tree kales and pretty much pull everything else. Underneath the overhang, we did pretty good. We had to water it by hand several times during the winter because it doesn't get the rain like out in the yard. Lettuces are doing really well. I planted cilantro near the front door because I love cilantro so much and it's more protected, so it stays a little bit warmer. It's been growing a lot faster than the cilantro not underneath the overhang. And things are bolting here too, so we're probably gonna, you know, get ready for pulling things out and preparing to buy summer plants, but not quite putting them in yet. See this bronze fennel keeps coming back every year. We cut it back and it just keeps coming back even stronger. And that's an amazing, has an amazing taste and flavor. Nice bronze color. Mmm, smells so good too. So we're getting all these pavers in, so that's a nice addition. Thanks to Sage for doing all this work. He's doing a great job. And so this is John Kohler with growingyourgreens.com. We'll see you next time. And remember, you can grow those greens. It's so easy. Just start.